Andy, from my vantage point, your work is unique in that it rests directly at the intersection of politics and the law. Your congressional oversight and investigations related matters often, seem to position you as both counsel and the communications person, even if behind the scenes, for high profile clients in high stakes matters. I also know, kind of from knowing you and your work, that you take a practical and business minded approach in your matters. When you're in the midst of these kind of high-profile matters, a client comes to you because they're being investigated, for example, and you are aware that the matter is going to result in significant media attention. Can you walk us through your approach, both on the investigation side and on the comms side, to best protect the client?
Yeah, it's a really good question. And, in congressional investigations, especially, the politics are driving it, and the politics are informed by the media environment. So the comms risk to a client is kind of often almost parallel to the political risk, because that might be what's driving the investigators in the House if they're getting a payoff. So you have to be immediately sensitive that there's a fusion between the investigation and the communications. And one of the things that I would just say right off the bat is one of my old mentors, Bob Bennett, used to tell clients when we would have our intake meeting about these types of investigations, like, you may have flunked the facts, but I'm not going to let you flunk the investigation. And I always sort of love that idea that there's sort of, there's what comes in the door hasn't already baked. And then there's how you manage the process of the investigation itself. And, it's the old adage, like, when you find yourself in a hole, what do you do? The first thing that you need to do is put down the shovel. And so, like, stop digging. And so I think that also relates to this discussion about, comms and how it affects the law and how it affects the political environment in which these types of investigations get done. And so I think one thing, just to walk through a couple of the back of the envelope things that I would want clients thinking about right away. One is just communications control, like just operational control, to make sure that their communications professionals, other people who might speak on the record, that they have visibility into the requests that are coming in, that the lawyers get a chance to review those requests, and that every communication about that matter is very intentional by the company at that point. So that's one thing I would just want to get my arms around, like, right away. Like, who's in the room? Who's going to know and have visibility into those decisions? And then you start doing an assessment of the legal risk, the comms risk, and the political risk. And so if you get the letter, you sort of like, how serious are these allegations if they were true? And so that's sort of important to get a sense of how big a ticket item this is going to be for the client. And then you start thinking about, okay, what actually happened? Like, we got a letter from, because some, congressional staffer saw a story that painted your client in a negative light, and they sent this letter. Is that true? And so then you start doing the factual assessment, and trying to figure out what happened, what the company knows and what it doesn't know. And that's another thing that really matters for comms, which is, and how it relates to investigations, which is, like, being very clear about what the company knows and what it doesn't know and know yet and what it needs to know, so that the communications are really driven by the facts. And you, one of the worst things you can do is have denials that turn out to be untrue later on when more facts come out. So I think, like, strategic and tactical pauses from saying something, even though you really want to say that didn't happen. Do we really know that didn't happen? So some of that, those conversations can be a little bit tough, but I think it's really important to sort of buck a little bit of the pressure to get an answer out quickly to make sure that it's correct. And, one of the points where this really intersects with the law is, and this goes to flunking an investigation, if you put out a public statement that has inaccurate information, and then everything you say to the congressional investigators or the FBI or everyone else is 100% true, the fact that it differs from the public statement is a prima facie case of dishonesty, both potentially for perjury investigation or for a false statements investigation. So, like, those public statements, even if they're not themselves regulated, the way they might just be different than statements you make to investigators could create legal liability that wasn't there, and it was just a comms impulse that happened, and maybe it didn't get legal review. So that's another thing I think is really important. Once you have a sense of the facts, then I think you do the traditional lawyer like legal risk. What are the legal risks here? Like if these, you know, based on what we know about the facts, based on the allegations, what's the statutory or regulatory scheme, and do that traditional legal work, and then how are we going to talk about it? And I think, again, in a congressional investigation, so much of the job that you're trying to do is to shape the political environment in a way that mitigates the risk that's coming and makes it less incentivized for the members to push harder and deeper and ask for more things and you know, really, like, you know, punish your client through investigative means. Another big piece of this for the comms, I think, dimension is mapping the committee. Like, what is driving this investigation? Is it just, you know, is it a geographic thing that's, like, peculiar to that chair and it's their district and, like, your client won a contract that their, you know, homegrown contractor didn't get? Is it partisan politics? Is your company really a means to an end to try and get at an administration of a different party? Like, someone going after the Biden administration through your company because someone in your company has a tie there. So you need to sort of assess what are what's driving this investigation, and then you can help the communications professionals and the legal documents try to mitigate that or address those concerns in a way that will make it a less juicy target for the investigators. And then the last thing I would just say, which I think is good advice for folks practicing in all sorts of areas, is to think about every document you send out, you know, to basically write the AP story you want written about your client's facts, law, and you know, intentions in the first two paragraphs of every letter, every legal filing, every, you know, conversation you have, because if that, you know, you have two audiences, right? There's the investigative committee itself, and then there's the public or the media. And so you want to make sure that if that document gets leaked, the company's own story is being told at the top. And it doesn't get your data doesn't sort of get disentangled from your story and your narrative that you're trying to push. Again, ensuring that that narrative is supported by sufficient facts to make the case.